difference, it is different. 250, 300 range, 250 range, and then you have 200 range, group 5, yeah, group 5, and the real two losers, that is group 4 and group 6. Okay, right. Now, I want you to, from the lower scores, group 6, maybe one guy can come to the front and explain what did you do, what went wrong, what strategy you followed, what was different in advanced scenario compared to adaptive scenario. Group 6. Quick, quick, 2-3 minutes. So share with us what did you do.
Should I come forward?
Yeah, yeah. So camera is coming. You can stand somewhere here. Yeah. So what people really wanted to do, how you kind of approached the situation?
Initially we wanted to just go on ultra capacity. Uh-huh. But then we realized our profits are declined.
Okay.
Then according to the news, we looked at the product features and required areas to develop. According to that, we decided to set budget to certain areas.
So basically you were focusing on existing business.
Yeah.
You are protecting the matured technology and the R&D investment focus and it was?
For some extent we invested on ultra capacitors, but not too much comparing to NIEMS.
But your advanced scenario has been better. Huh?
Yeah.
How kind of managed? Because you get fired on the day?
We did get fired. Actually, our first attempt, we were focusing more on ultra capacitors.
Okay.
So, the current system will be focusing more on existing systems.
Okay, so now they learn from their interactive session that maybe ultra capacitor is kind of sexy technology, new technology, but it's not really like giving profit, so they try to manage it, existing business and allocating R&D and try to improve the situation. Anybody want to ask any questions from them? Anybody want to say from the same group? Add something on the presentation? Okay, thank you very much, sir. Next is group, yes. So, please, group 4. So they have introduction, introductory scenario 74, advanced scenario 71. So they actually they were consistent in terms of performance, but they couldn't get go higher or they didn't get also drop. So what did you do and how did you think? What went wrong? How much did you decide?
Both scenarios actually we followed the news.
So these are, there are some CEOs, they always do the read the newspaper. Yes. So this is that kind of, yes. But that means you are looking at the environment factors.
Yes. We continuously invested on nickel metal hydride rather than the alpha capacitors. And so because the sales forecast shows that the nickel metal hydride is higher than the alpha capacitors. Therefore, we can also invest in nickel metal hydride. So, after a couple of years, time, so we decline on sales.
So, now you understand that even though you are doing well, very well in nickel metal hydroxide, so you wanted to stay in the business or you want to expand into ultra capacitor?
While staying on nickel metal hydride business.
Okay. Why you want to stay there?
Sorry.
Why you wanted to stay there?
Because when you look at the sales revenue,
okay.
So higher growth is coming.
Okay. So you this is your main business. So you don't want to drop your existing customers and profit. And then you were incrementally trying to get into the ultra capacitor, or you just dropped nickel metal hydroxide and went to ultra capacitor?
No, the incrementally we just want to make it into the ultra capacitor.
Did it work?
I didn't.
And why? What do you think? Why this happened like this? How did you allocate research R&D? Small amount everywhere?
No, basically when we allocated the R&D, we allocated the major in the basic side.
Okay, okay.
And we sell recharge area also.
So you look at some custom segment?
Yes.
And then try to not to satisfy everybody or satisfy everybody?
Satisfy for the particular goals and market segment.
And anything from the group? Anything else you want to add? Yes?
In the second scenario, our syrup focus was wrong something.
Okay.
So we reduced the sales focus as well as sometimes we had to reduce our price focus.
So basically, when you are reducing your sales focus, what is the result on that for your decisions in the future? If you have low sales focus, that means you won't get fired because you are in the range of management objectives. But what is the problem with that? What is the negative? Low sales forecast means? R&D, your budget is a percentage of your sales forecast. So you will have less money to invest in your project. And as a result of that, your profit will also not go high. But you can, did you get fired in that?
To survive only we have damage.
Ah, okay, but then that means you focus on long-term survival than risk-taking in the short term. Anybody who want to ask questions from the group audience, from other groups? Okay, sir, thank you very much. Next, what is the next group? Group number five. Group number five. Yes, sir. Little bit there.
Thank you.
So this is a common mistake. You want to serve everybody. You are not really strategic because you don't want to lose your market and you also don't want to give up a new opportunity. So as a result of that, you won't be able to get gold. So this is the example that they lost. Now compared to one previous group, this new group said we will give up ultra capacity but we focus on nickel cadmium. So that is a strategy. You be conservative but you have a strategy, but now what they were doing, they don't want even give up ultra capacity because you know you are greedy about the future potential. You know it's going to be, you can sell at a higher price, but then at the moment you won't get profit from ultra capacity. So it's a trade-off decision. Any comment from the group? Any questions from the audience? Thank you very much, sir. Group number 3. Yes, sir. They have 181, which is very good in instructor session. So they were like early learners. I also saw that their working was very good as a team. And they also have good results in advanced scenario, but lost from 140.
Yes, sir. Actually, large portions of revenue came through the NIMH because 80% of revenue came through that. So we highly concerned about that product, and then we want to look after and concern about the market news because we want to measure what are the changes coming on the external party, external environment. So according to the external environmental changes, we focus on the unit prices as well as unit sales amount, and according to the changes, as example, in the power tool demands goes down, then we give some price discount for the prices as well as some make some reductions, reduce some quantities on the unit sales. Then we could able to get some profits as well as we. Yeah, after every year, we are highly concerned about the year-end profits coming through the both products. And then we target to achieve 0 points, take care of 0 points profits from the ultra capacity because we we gave some small concerns about that product. So that's how we could able to gain some these kinds of profits.
Now, from what you said, what I gathered was actually they were very specific. Now they went into detail. They looked at different reports. They were paying attention to different dimensions. That is actually showing, for example, real business thinking. Because now some groups I have seen like they are trying to get figure out somehow by doing maybe many trials. But they, these guys, like, I remember they were like doing low time, some kind of analysis, and they are very slow. But that is very good because now you, and then you get the depth of understanding about if you, for example, they say, after zero profit, maybe that's a good idea because you don't want to earn profit out of your business. You want to be in the business, you get profit from nickel metal hydroxide, but you take care of this, what you call this, BCG metrics. You have cash cow, you have stars, you have problem child or dogs. Now, maybe ultra capacity for you was a problem child because you don't earn profit, but you want to, what you call, nourish the child. You want to let the child go. Maybe after 5 years you will learn profit. Whereas ultra nickel metal hydroxide is like more like a cash cow. You can earn profit out of cash cow. Anything you want to add from the group? Don't worry. So anything from the audience? Questions? Comments of the group? So they have done like decent job in completing the simulation.
Thank you very much, sir.
So we have our final winners. Group number, I forgot.
One?
I sure. Yeah, group number one. Yes, sir, go ahead.
You won last time also, no?
You too?
Yes.
Last time also you won. No?
Maybe you are lucky guys. Yes.
Actually, for the second one, we actually reduced some marks because of one reason. Because initially we thought the investment. working on UC is a key effective. But as all of you mentioned, it is a problem by the scale stages. But if we keep like 2030 or 40, it will be a cash cow for our organization. That is one area that we focused on. And first one is when we look at the news, we saw our competitors are reducing their unit prices. So according to that, we adjusted our unit prices. And also, and we focus more on process improvement. Because if we reduce our unit prices, people demand more, and our process needs to be perfect to give their sales and their demand. And the next one is, we increase the unit price of UCs because we got an idea that people who are buying those things will buy it anyhow. So we increase those prices of UCs when the year increased to 2020. And last one is that if you have looked at the sheet very carefully, there was an, according to our understanding, there is a line which says forecast and 2013 sales forecast. So if you look at it, it has plus and positive signs. Maybe you can use it as a hint when you are submitting, because if you have, but you can't too much depend on it, but the gap is less, it will be a good indicator for you to predict for your next year.
That's for advanced area. Okay, so right now, if you look at their performance, actually they have performed compared to all other groups in both scenarios. 186, that is like best trial of all among all, and also advanced scenario 170. Now, for example, this group, it is number two, no? So they are like slightly lower than them, but they both in a kind of similar diameter. There are some groups always moderate, some groups are very high. And but they lost. Now, for example, group number three, construction is very good. But these guys, for example, group number two, they had the first very good 164, but scenario two was 83, so they lost. Now this group shows that, for example, two or three analysis and serious decisions, you can actually perform. Now this is what I wanted to do to have to do. You are not trying to understand how simulation works, but you look at this from business point of view. Now, as you mentioned, the forecast indicator will give you an idea about whether you are very high in your forecast or you are doing okay. So now as a business, you should always look at all indicators about future, all predictions, analysis, forecast, to make your decision. I think they have done also in that case. Anything from the group, the winning group? How was work in the group? How did you manage? Because I see sometimes two groups, three groups, the same group.
Yeah, actually, the idea is that was in the group team.
Okay.
Actually, we were in the first one and the next group in the second one.
Okay, so now for example, now personally, I think for four people per group will be the ideal, because then you can have a group discussion and do, but I made it anyway for business control and everything. Otherwise, anyway, that I saw that people are working in separate groups, but that's all fine as far as we construct for you. Any questions to the winner in the team? They're jealous. No? Okay, thank you very much. So you will get great. Based upon your kind of overall categorization, but I'm sure both of you get A. So the people, they have to decide. But also I will now decide actually grade once you submit your email, because this is the weakest point. So they never submit, huh? Then so please submit one of your scores. Any questions up now? Okay, great. So let me just go through some kind of wrap up in terms of simulation. You can actually reverse back. You can come back to the original version. Still there also no problem, but this we have to do the board. So when you look at your results, now simulation also very interesting, because here in our portal, you have all the
information for me as the president, how you have done. But now, if you do this really in a standard way, actually you are logging as separate people and it will cost $45. You can save how many dollars. This is a government university and the trial, so we pay money. Now, this will give you an idea about all the trials we have already done up now. There are 65 trials to start it, and you have completed only 28 trials. I don't know how they came in two, but it's one user. Now, for example, if you look at advanced scenario, for this advanced scenario, and now we have an interactive scenario. Let's look at the best scenario. Or is the worst scenario? The worst scenario, some people are maybe they are abundant, but interactive session. Let's look at you can look at those files. Yeah, so somebody got 298, but nobody will actually written that.
That's the one
you refused. Ah, okay. So it's out of the content. So one takes it. So you see this, people have done. Okay, now for example, if I want to look at how you have done, this is your strategy. So it's group one. And also I can look at your mission or your results as a PDF file. So each trial you can do. So as a courtesy to you, Guru, I'll show them how you have done your best scenario. So see what they have done. They have been able to maintain, actually they have focused on nickel metal hydroxide. But then they have not been able to kind of improve ultra capacity business revenue. Those in details. You can see how they have invested. They actually lost. I mean, they maybe they now for example at the beginning they invested more money on nickel metal hydroxide energy density, but they kept on kind of giving up or reducing. Now this one is so they focus mainly three areas, right? So they are energy density. Performance has gone up to the investment money. So if you want to improve your product features, you are into invest charge the cycle for startup. They are you invest money in our startup capacitor, the charge of cycle. Here again, implemental side, you can see that way. So your product cost for both cases goes down. And important thing is now you can see they have been able to manage profitability. That is important because even though your sales are not very high, both in both cases your profit are positive. But you got more profit from single printing hydroxide. So that is same way you can look at all the trials you have done. So that is how you do that. Also I can look at you can also export this Excel file. Okay, so this is individual performance. Let's see how you have in the hand. This is how you have done in terms of again, I can look at profit and better and you can see the summary in different areas. Profit growth. Sales force. can see minimum maximum equal to 980 bits. So you can look at different how they have treated sales, considering trends, everything in graph. Now this this breathing graph actually based on your performance. It is immediately managed. This last result. So if you summarize now how you have what you have done, so the idea is that you follow some strategies, but you have to understand underlying theories. How, for example, as I said, product this is demanded. So you should link this thinking or your action in terms of what is the kind of theory behind that. And also we talk about now ultra capacitive disruptive technology like 3D printing. So it will disrupt existing industry, that is nickel cadmium, nickel metal hydroxide technology, or even lithium ion technology. Now this emerging technology, so electricity is going to disrupt the industry. Now how you as a company use it? You want to have it accepted immediately, or you want to wait? And a lot of people actually were saying, no, you will not really pay attention to ultra capacitive now, maybe in the future, but you will defend your market, or else you can think, no, ultra capacitive is very good, and then you go for that. So how do you evaluate their performance also, whether you want to invest or you want to hold or not to invest? So at the moment, in this case, at the beginning, your nickel metal hydroxide business was very good, you were earning profit, and the assets are also growing. So even the technology was not really new, but you had decent market of profitability in that business. Now, you also have to look at which customer segment you are serving. Now, here you can say that power tool manufacturers are normally happy with your product, and therefore, maybe you have to allocate research and development to features they are demand. For example, power tool manufacturers are asking for better energy density and chargeable time. Now these are some opportunities you have, you can think about investing, but and of course they are all promising, but then it will not automatically give you profitability even though you invest in future profit. However, as somebody already mentioned, like investment in ultra capacitors will take years to give the return. So therefore, now I think last group also highlighted that both groups. If you want to be profitable and stay in the business, take care of your best customers. That is what they kept on saying. Even though new disruptive technologies are coming, they have promising profit, but first you have to maintain your profit. So therefore, please invest to protect your existing good customers. But somebody was talking about paying attention to news and reading news. Of course, you will always look at all these news and negative news, positive news, comparative news. But it is very difficult to just cater to all these trends, cater to all environmental factors. Maybe you will listen to them, but you will still keep strong hold on what you are doing. Maybe you will react to them, but you have to understand as managers, you can't react to all the future news. Now, even ultra capacitive, maybe some new technology will come and ultra capacitive will be outdated. I think that happened to in Sri Lanka, for example, in telecommunication industry, if you look at CDMA. CDMA, when it came, it was really, really sexy and it was there a lot of advertisement. But after 5 years, 4G came, 3G came, and now CDMA is like outdated. So therefore, some technologies come as like a promising technology, but maybe not necessarily going to guarantee you future profit. So now, if your sales are declining, if you abandon nickel metal hydroxide in your current business, then there will be serious implication on you will not be able to make profit. Now, if you don't have profit, you can't have R&D to allocate in other areas. So
So it's very important that you predict also your sales forecast correctly, particularly under advanced scenario. Somebody was saying that you want to maintain zero profit. Who was saying that? This group, no? So that is a good idea, because now if you look at any group, they were still earning losses or negative profit. So maintaining zero profit is a good strategy. That means you are trying hard to get some profit out of there. So again, now as I was discussing one group, you can save money without spending on R&D, but the main challenge is you need to have more R&D than what is available to you. Particularly under advanced scenario, you don't have enough money, but there are a lot of places where you can invest. Okay, so let's look at your best results. Now, most of you have the cumulative, all of your summaries. You have been able to manage cumulative profit between this price, but you can see some of you have also many losses. Not many people have been able to go to 600 and above, right? So this is like the normal format. In terms of revenue, some people have been able to get very high sales. That means these things are like to sell more. Not really to earn profit, but to get more in these trials. They have earned a lot of sales. So maybe by using discounts, reducing prices, they might have earned it. But most of the revenues are between 60 million to 120 million. That is overall revenue. Ultra capacitors, you want to earn much money than in nickel cadmium. You can see now, only one fly would go to 120. And about this sales, profitability trend means like an indicator of profitability. You can't say they are very good. I think most of the trials actually lost than you earn money, because minus two. Last range, we have almost all the trial, but maybe one trial had a very high profitability. The other capacity is very clear compared to this one. It's still losing money. Yes, growth. So there are different things you can look at your results. Now, in terms of theoretical background of the simulation, you have to understand that now when you are analyzing, when you are sitting in the general manager's office, president's office, there's a lot of data, you have a lot of reports to analyze, a lot of information you have to process, external as well as internal. But again, the limitation is this all about past decision. When you start taking all the complaints in 2012, you are 2010, 2011. 2010, 12 results, but these are already decided and you know the history, you know what has happened, but you don't have enough experience or enough information to talk about what is going to happen. I think the gentleman has back mentioned also, you have to look at different ways why to analyze the analyze or predict the future. But a lot of our reports are about our past. Now, this is an important kind of concept. I will not go into details, but you will learn this, or you will have to learn it again and again, whether it is about Uber, company Uber, how they disrupt taxi industry. I'm sure a lot of you know about Uber, right? That's the application, a tax app. Or Airbnb, that home renting company. Or 3D printing, all these are disruptive technologies. How disruptive technology will affect your current business. Now here, you see this is your performance, and this is the performance target expected by the customers. You can see it's improving over the period of time. Now this is established business, and this is the new business, emerging technology. Now to some extent, it improves to some performance level, customers are not accepting. Whether it's 3D printing, whether it's 4G, whether it's any other technology, you have to have some improvement over the period, some improvement of performance expectations of the customers, then only customers will accept. But you as a company, if you want to get the benefit, you have to invest in that.
But at the beginning, you should know that these are not really earning, giving you very profit. This is how you look at this stuff to technology. Now, for example, in this case, ultra capacitors was not good enough for many clients. Even though you, by analysis, you can say this is very good, it's going to be future, but not many customers who have real application based material will not accept it till it is established in the market. And also, you should know your disruption technology is improving performance, improving customer acceptance over the period of time. So, for example, based on this graph, now when a new technology exceeds this performance level, then only customers will accept this as sufficient to buy, and then only you get the goal, critical mass. So till you get critical mass from your customer, this will not be profitable in technology, but you can still try to maintain and work with that. So of course, as we saw, there are a lot of R&D opportunities for you to invest, but you have less budget, so how do you allocate your R&D into different ventures? But it's very important that only if you invest in R&D, you make your product features better in the future, and the result of that to the But important thing here is now, for example, allocating R&D budget is not R&D decision. It is a strategy issue. It is affecting your profit. It is affecting your finance. It is affecting your marketing, product performance, customer satisfaction, customer relationship management, manufacturing. So it's multi-functional decision. That's why it's called strategic decision or strategic management. Here you can see, now when you talk about technologies, you can see that technology import or the nature of technological change can be considered high or low, less or more. Say here that means more influential changes or less changes. This is called base technology, that means don't change much how you are doing. So maybe you can talk about improvement of your technology. So all these projects that you are thinking about investing can be categorized as how much to contribute to change. So base technology, technology which will improve your process, next generation of technology, and then radical technology. Again, I want to highlight you, remember we talk about 3D printing as next industrial revolution. That means it will radically change the way we do business. It is not just improving your process. Maybe you can have technology to improve your process for your productivity and things like that. Now, let's say when you introduce 3G to 4G is a next generation of technology. But a radical change means entire new paradigm. So that is how you kind of classify different technology. And then you can talk about impact on the market. More impact, less impact, more impact. So you can have radical technology, but maybe it won't be kind of affecting the market. So when you have radical technology, it creates a new market. I keep on telling, digital fabrication will create new market, right? People who have printer can be on the printer. So that will be a break. Through technology, with radical technology and create new market. And platform technology is where you have next generation technology will impact in terms of reaching to new customers. So those are called platform projects. And if you are undertaking technology which will improve your processes and impact is comparatively low, you can sell more product to existing customers, those are derivative projects. And of course, the importance is less to the market and technological upgrade is less. This can be just support to technology. So these are how you look at different technological projects and how you categorize them based on their importance, their technological dimension as well as
impact on the market. Now, now in this case, for example, we are talking about battery. Battery is not like proper science or anything very complex. Actually, everybody has the same technology, whether it's nickel, cadmium, different oxide. Those are commodities. So you have in-terms technology, everybody can access that. So it is very important that for the time, how to price such kind of product. It's a commodity, you should be able to produce it in a very efficient manner and then get sell at the best price and over a period of time how you change the price. But however, if you can differentiate your battery or any other product, you can sell it at a higher price. So if you don't do R&D, if you are still asking more higher price, the customers will not buy and you will be kind of destroying your own company. But it's very important, one way is you can consider like nickel melting or hydroxide is not a premium product, it's a commodity, so we just sell as many as possible by giving low prices. Or you can see ultra capacity is going to be a premium product, so therefore you do some product differentiation by having more R&D. So these are an condition you take every year as you give in your simulation. So this is another decision. Are you patient enough to wait till ultra capacitor give you profit? If you are impatient, if you want to maintain your profitability today, this year, next year, maybe you should not think about ultra capacitor, but try to get more money, more profit, more nickel metal hydroxide. But if you decide, no, we don't mind losing money on ultra capacitor now and next 2013, 2014, because I want to have more business coming from ultra capacitor in 2018, 19, 20. So that is a different way of looking at short term versus long term profit. I'm sure you had those discussions in your group. So these are two examples how one person did that day and another person did another day. The point is the simulation has no right answer. There's no one way to get the maximum. There can be different ways, but depending upon your business specification. So I will not go and do it. Now these are some of the challenges. Very difficult price a capacitor because human investment, you don't know how it is priced by other people. We don't know that, like objective way of estimating sales or even pricing. So for example, here as you can see, if you do not perform well conservatively for 3 years, you will be fired. It's very common. Or else, if you make blunder, that is typical Sri Lankan example because we have very high expectation from like the president or prime minister, everyone we know HR, blah blah blah. But in real life, 50% people fail all over max. So how can you make such kind of claims? That are this hub and this hub, but you have to have a real working objective estimation about your company or your market. So the point is now, the limitation maybe of the simulation, when you are targeting profitability, maybe good decisions are focused. You don't want to look at the current good decisions because you want to maintain profit. So therefore maybe, for example, if you had a different way of assessing your success or performance in your simulation, you will be doing a different thing. But when I say you have to maximize cumulative profit, so you want to go for that target. Maybe some of your musicians, for example, you like ultra capacity, ultra friendly, ultra capacity, blah blah blah. Those things you don't consider because you will allocate R&D where you get the best profit. So it's a critical discussion should be discussed on looking at only cumulative profit as a success factor. In marketing, I think we look at different criteria. In also project management, we look at different criteria. But in this simulation, we look at cumulative profit. And in project management, we look at also motivation level of people as a factor that will be considered in your scope, simulation scope. But here, we look at over the 8 period of time, what is your cumulative profit. So whatever gives you highest profit, you will go for that. So it's sometimes questionable. But the point is, now when you leave after 2020, you are president and you leave, what kind of business you will hand over to next generation or next president? When you got the presidency in 2012, what is the business you had? Now have you added value or have you destroyed the company? Some of you try to show that you destroyed entire and destroyed the company by having a very low negative profit. But some of you have done better. So those are some of the issues. The final I want to highlight here, now what we did was actually the point here is actually I would say that now what you did today is actually your ultimate MBA test. So maybe you have been good in marketing, you have good in finance or IT, but if you want to strategic game or strategic project this way, you are not going to be good general managers. So as strategic management, now you now I don't want to highlight anything, but when you are doing this, you understood the difficulty of taking decisions because you have to manage different criteria. So how you manage that? That is what you will do in real life as general manager. Not immediately some of you already doing, some of you will be doing this during next 2 years. You will definitely be doing it in next 5 years. So the idea I just want to tell you is actually that most of you will be doing general management. You will see that you can't say that I am from IT background. I think I remember when I first asked in first day, they say I am in IT, so I don't know banking. I am in banking, therefore I don't know IT. You can't have such kind of statement when you are MBA, when you are in general management. It is your job or your role is to maximize profit. 5 years, 10 years, how you run the company and get the cumulative profit higher. So therefore that will be your focus. And to do that, you have understanding about finance, you have understanding about operations, IT, accounting, law, HR, all other functions. So that is the idea of MBA, first of all, and that is also the idea of strategy. So how you do things done now that we did in our trade liberalization exercise. I don't really care whether trade tie is good or bad, it is going to destroy us, it is going to give us like heaven. No, that is not the approach. That is the approach for layman, that is the approach for functional expert. Economy say, based on this theory, this is good. Professionals or somebody else say, politicians say, blah, 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 this is not good. That is not the strategy's job. Strategy job is, you have task to perform. How you do it best? That is the approach we do. So in also in when you are going to be a strategic manager, general managers, CEOs, that is now deciding whether you take the job or not is a different thing. You know? So once you are in the CEO position, you can say they have done been unfair, I don't have enough resources, I don't have enough time, I'm not feeling fit enough. Then you don't accept the job. Right? But that means if you are not an MBA, you are a IT guy, so you keep on doing IT for next 20 years, 30 years, and you die as honorable IT employee of the company with your retirement. But if you say that I want to be the CEO and I want to run this company, I want to take care of other people's future, then you don't have excuses, I don't know, I am new, I just started this. No, your job is how to get things done, because there are some people expecting your decision, your input to decide their life. So that is the approach you should have. And I think this small exercise in a very small scale gave you that opportunity, because willing or unwilling, knowing you or unknowing it, but it was you ran a company, maybe 2 hours, but you were thinking like a CEO. Now even CEOs just do for today, right? Like, okay, just put that figure there, fine. So people do it, huh? You get very senior manager say, okay, no, R&D project allocate to process improvement, because you are lazy to think what is the implication of allocating R and O to ultra cavity. That is fine, arbitrary, fluctuating, those things matter, but what you did was actually running a company. So those, this will be your maybe life every day after 5 years to 10 years, I don't know, 2 years. Then you want to be CEO after how many years? Tomorrow? Are you ready now? Good. So that's the idea. So that is actually the orientation of simulation. I personally think you should actually have simulation for all the subjects, at least for management subject for the second year, marketing, finance, organization behavior, financial management, team building, so there are a lot of simulations. By doing that, you will, one thing is you learn how difficult to manage all the competing objectives. Second thing, you get confident after doing that. You feel like you have run a company. Yeah? Anybody feels good after doing simulation? But if you feel, for example, oh my god, I could have not done this machine and something like that, maybe you should not be in MBA. Yeah? Because this, you know, I like only IT and I want to be in IT. And then, actually, I just posted a video. Also, they have interviewed Bill Gates and Mark Zuckerberg. They are saying every citizen should learn programming. Because in the US, it's a big problem because people are thinking mathematically, so therefore writing a code and writing programs is very difficult for them. So they were advising that young people should learn coding or doing programming. It's also a good idea, but I think my actually thinking is all citizens, or at least people who do A-level, should do a strategy course, small strategy course. Then you will learn things about problems, maybe managing problems, other problems. In a different, you know, called bird's eye view, you look at problems not like this or like this, but like this. You look from the top. So then you see marketing, IT, everything as a part of your problem. But what we see now here is actually functional experts look at problems in their own way. So you talk to economists, they will talk about what is good and what is bad. Talk to engineers, they will talk about their knowledge. But my kind of suggestion and, you know, appeal is to think strategy and work on that regardless of your current job, regardless of your current expertise. Now after MBA you have to because you are like few privileged people who have experience on doing strategy. This is the kind of benefit you have. Don't forget that. After this class, after MBA, you don't go and cry saying that I can't do, I can't speak, I'm afraid, I'm shy, I don't have capability, I can't speak English, I can't do IT. You know, a lot of people say. So that is kind of a general complaint or general idea. Okay, anything else? Any comments from you? Yellow comments? Good? Yes, ma'am? You want to say something? Everybody want to say something? Okay. So my final, I think this is our last day. So you will have 10% of your grading today, 20 from your individual assignment, 10 from your class participation and research, 10% from group presentation, so you get 50. Some you might get like 40.